I'm Dawn Schreibman, and I'm here to talk to you today about how exercise a day can keep your doctor away. There is many things that I'm going to tell you in this presentation that will help you. And in my younger years, this is what I used to look like. I was a pro bodybuilder. I won many competitions, so I know what I'm talking about. I want to convince you to exercise. I believe that every single person should exercise to stay or become healthy. I am passionate about the positive effects that physical exercise. This will benefit you physically, mentally, and social in all ways of life. I'm going to explain in depth the physical, mental, and social. Physical is to explore the human anatomy and growth from exercise. Mental is to delve into the brain and to explore what makes exercise feel good. Social, to realize that to be human, you need humans, and exercise is a good outlet to relate to others. Obviously, if there is something that can potentially harm you, you shouldn't do it. Physical exercise should always be challenging, but never dangerous or hurt you. I can attest that being physical is not some people's forte. However, I am living proof that it has many benefits. I have been exercising since I was a child, doing gymnastics and all kinds of different things to keep my body fit. As I grew older, I stopped doing some of those activities, but still, I exercised many times during the week. There's no guarantee for living a long life, but thanks to my healthy habit, I don't suffer from a lot of things that my peers suffer from, like high blood pressure and strength and endurance problems. I don't have those. I have been a professional personal trainer and certified in kinesiology, physiology, diet, nutrition, and all types of other modalities from college to be fit today. I have helped hundreds of people, and those that have come to my side being physically fit are still physically fit to this day. Today, I will be talking to you about the physical, mental, and social benefits of exercise. Everyone wants to live a longer life, right? Unfortunately, we do not have the recipe for immortality. Fortunately, we do know that exercising can help prolong the inevitability and make life a little less complicated. I have spent over 40 years in the exercise and mental health education field. Therefore, it is to your benefit to heed my lecture today. There is a concerning increase of obesity and unhealthy lifestyles becoming into the United States. For many years now, it leads to debilitating, potentially fatal diseases such as diabetes, heart problems, and a plethora of other different things that can go wrong with you. My three arguments for this subject are: how is it going to benefit you physically? How is it going to benefit you mentally? And how is it going to benefit you socially? I, as an advocate of this modality of life, encourage each and every one of you, no matter what your physical or social or mental deficits are, you can acquire more than what you think you could do. There's a plethora of things that you can do, from walking, going to the park, doing pull-ups. You can find things in your house to exercise with. These little weights are very inexpensive. You could use cans. You can do all kinds of things. Once you adapt to this daily activity and goal, you'll start to feel a lot better, and you'll get heightened self-esteem, and you'll continue the adventure and grow physically, mentally, and socially. Only a few lifestyle choices have as large an impact on your health as physical activity. People who are physically active are about 33% at lower risk for getting debilitating diseases. How is this going to impact you mentally? In fact, increasing robust evidence suggests that exercise is not only necessary for the maintenance of good mental health, but it can be used to treat even chronic mental illness. And that's from Psychology 2018. The one prior was from the CDC 2020. How is this going to benefit you socially? Participating in group activities gets you out to socialize, and it enhances your brain capacity to make friendships. So you can, it benefits you immensely. According to an exercise specialist, get into a group of friends together and go hiking, exploring at a state park, sign up for team sports, find local fitness classes, get a dog and take walks. Sign up for a road race. This was from Riverview Health 2017. Time is not a factor when you are starting, but it is better to do a few minutes than none. If you do not know what to do and are restricted with time and money, there is several different apps on your phone or computer that will teach you exercise that you can do at home. And it doesn't take that long, such as the Home Workout app, which you can download from the Play Store or App Store. Once you have built the endurance, you will realize that you can achieve longer durations of activity. Money can enhance the different avenues of adventure. Hang gliding, water skiing, snowboarding, those are expensive, but they're really fun to do. I myself do them. You don't need to do that though. Even if you're in a wheelchair, there's certain exercises that you could do. You could open your mouth, you can move your head back and forth, sideways, lift your shoulders. There's a lot of different exercises that you can do. A simple Google search will help you. You can hire a personal trainer, or if you have debilitating things, you can hire a physical therapist. People have alternate ideas to exercise, food deprivation, which means that they starve themselves or go on crazy diets. This is not the answer, and some of my patients have become anorexic because of it, and it's very sad. And unless you're going to keep that lifestyle, like continue to run races and things like that, it's very hard. Being active is more than effective than any diet because it gives your brain endorphins, almost like an antidepressant like Prozac or Effexor. I'm not telling you not to take your meds. Take your meds. But I'm saying that it is really good. Some people always look an excuse not to exercise, saying they're too tired, they work too hard, they had a stressful day. When in fact, having a stressful day, it's even more important that you exercise because it really helps relieve stress. Exercise doesn't stop from here though. Not only does it help you get healthy in many ways, but it will have a newfound and view on yourself. You also start being able to do things that you might have not been able to before, like carry two grocery bags, put more laundry in the laundry basket, be able to take a walk or push your grandchild and, you know, do many things. I have shared with you my strong accolades of how moving and somehow, some way can reap benefits to exercise being physically, mentally, and socially. My purpose was to educate you and to push you to my side. I know that people that have gone to my side are still physically fit. Make sure you take time to plan to do something that consists of moving. We all want to live as long as possible. With exercising, we can do that. I want to encourage all of you to get up and move, to exercise, and please try it. You'll like it. And exercise a day will keep the doctor away. Thanks for listening.